In the previous screencast, I showed how to set up and solve a set of ordinary differential equations and initial value problem and make a plot of the results. So here we'll show a few other things that one can make the plots look better and then also add comments. And so all we need to do to enter comments, if I hit the down arrow and see this horizontal line, when I select this, I can select plain text. And then I can put in text that does not correspond to any commands to Mathematica, is just to explain what this program solution is about. And I can enter more information. I can look at the plot. This is the plot we obtained from these commands. But if I want the plot to have certain attributes, I can easily change those in the plot commands. So within the plot command, I'm going to put a comma here. I'm going to add a frame, capital letter, dash, and the right arrow. True means a frame will show up. Now if I hit shift enter, it put a frame around the plot. If I want to label the axes of the frame, I can go back into the plot command, another comma. The command is frame label, again, dash and the right arrow. Within these brackets, I'm going to type in what I want on the axis, where each of them is in quotes. First, I'm going to put this on a new line to make it easier to see, so enter. So it's x-axis first, and then y-axis. The x-axis is time, and the y-axis is concentration. So now, shift enter. You notice on the plot, I have concentration label on the y-axis and time label on the x-axis. I can also put a title, essentially a label for this frame. Again, within the plot command, another comma, and the command is plot label, in the arrow, style, and then square brackets for function. So what I want to show up is in quotes, and I'm just going to call this batch reactor. Hitting shift enter, I create a label on the top. If I like to have a larger font within this plot label style, I can again put a comma and indicate the font size. Again, the arrow. And let's try 16. Hit shift enter, and we have a bigger font. Can also change the thickness of the lines. It's in the plot command. Let's add it in here. So the command then is plot style. Again, the arrow and thickness. And now square brackets and the thickness I'm going to use 0.005. And remember, I have to now put a comma after this option. This corresponds to 0.5% of the height of the graph. Shift enter. You can see the lines got thicker. Now I could have put some of the commands that I want to show up for my plot. I could just set at the beginning, set options. Again, in brackets, this is for the plot function. And so I could have said frame here, and it will automatically then set up the frame, and let's just remove it from here so we're not having the command twice. And I could set some other options. One is the label style. Again, the arrow, then within brackets. If I want a certain font to show up, like Arial, and it has to be in quotes. If I put a comma here, I can also add another command for the font size. And let's go with 14. Semicolon. So now I've added these options, and I could just copy this, for example, for every program. Again, shift enter, and now the fonts have changed to Arial, and now are size 14. And there are lots of other options in terms of making the graphs easier to read. For now, we'll stop with just these, being able to solve the differential equation quickly in Mathematica, and then picking some options to make the plot easier to read and understand.